Oh, this is a great video. We're going to fix three things that are missing from Power Query in Macintosh. So, great news, 2023, the Power Query debuts in Macintosh. But it doesn't support three things that we really need from table or range, from web, from folder, or from PDF. And in this video, long video, I admit, we're going to fix from table or range, from web, and from folder even, which requires a little bit of, believe it or not, one line of VBA. So thanks to Suat from Mr. Excel. He joined me via Teams this morning. Let's take a look. And today with me, I have Suat Ozgur, who is my resident Mac expert here at Mr. Excel. He's joining us via Teams, and he has figured out solutions to all three of those. This is great. I'm going to talk to Suat. We're going to see how you can do all three of those today in Power Query for the Mac. Suat, how are you today?
Hi, Bill. Thank you very much. I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing great. I can't wait to see what you have to show us today. All right.
Let's start with the file. Let's start from the table range.
Table and range. That's the one. Every time I'm in Power Query, I'm using from table or range because I'm just demoing something quick.
In Mac, there's no such options. There are so many options in Windows, but on Mac, we only stuck with this 9 options for now. Of course, I believe that they are going to add all of them in time.
Okay.
This is still great work, but we don't have the essential one.
Right.
Data from range on Mac. We have to do an extra step here. Okay. We need to create a table first. On Windows, it does that automatically, but here we need to do that. So I created my table here. And I name it like something sample table.
Okay.
And I get this name. And let's just go to Power Query and open the Power Query editor. The new query, blank query. Okay. All we need is using a single line mcot here. And I'm just going to copy and paste it here. We are using Excel current workbook and using the sample table. Okay, we just got this table here, and we can just close and load, and we just need to format dates or whatever, but it's simply the table data coming from the current range, and then we can just work with this data.
Okay, and then let's see, how do I get back into that query? So normally data, queries, and connections edit the query. How do you edit the query in Mac?
In Mac, we still have queries and connections. And if I click on queries and connections, it doesn't open a sidebar here.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Instead, it just opened this, but still, I cannot go to
There's no edit. Okay.
No, there's no. But we can still go to Power Query editor, and then our query is that. So we can just edit our query here.
Okay, so now that you have the table, let's do something with it. Let's pivot, So choose category.
Category.
Pivot column.
Yeah. And makes sense. Now we have this.
Yeah.
And we can use everything from here, just like in Windows. But we have these little icons here. With, maybe as the table.
From table or range. All right. And it's just one line of code. I'm going to put that in a little notepad file. Anytime I need to do from table or range, I'll just copy from the notepad, paste into the editor, and change the table name to match. And we're good to go.
Because when we see something doesn't exist here, you know,
you just assume it doesn't work. Yeah, right.
Yeah, it just doesn't work.
let's do web. Let's do web next because web is simple, right?
Yeah, web is simple actually. Yes, this is a web server that returns this JSON data, okay, from Mr. Excel books, and then I'm just going to use this API.
Okay.
And what we need to do is using the web contents command and converting its content as a JSON to a list, a table. This is the actual line. We are getting web contents by using this URL, and then we are converting it to something meaningful.
Okay.
So we just need to use this line. And the next, and then we got the data, just as we are going to do in Windows, but still, we have a two table. So we just convert this list to a table, and then expand columns here. And then, yeah, we got the web data.
Nice. Okay.
And just access this data. And still, it doesn't make sense why they don't have this here.
Both of those are a single line of code, right? It's not that hard.
Definitely.
The third topic today is how to get all of the files from a folder, right? Which is one of the beautiful things that's been in Windows Power Query since almost the very beginning.
This was really difficult than the other two. Mac doesn't let you to explore folders freely. Again, I need to create my query myself and blank query. Okay, this is the file. This is the command line. This is the command that I can get the files from a folder. Gmod desktop and let's name data folder, right? Data folder. I do this. No, it doesn't let me. But no, I can't access this.
Okay. And this is the Mac sandboxing system preventing you from doing that, right?
Yes. It also happens in VBA. Okay. When I try to access a folder, it just blocks me. But different from Power Query, it is just asking me to grant access to that folder, to exile. So if we go to VBA on Mac, which...
Let's assume that a lot of viewers have never used VBA on the Mac. And here we are in Excel. We have to do this one line of code in VBA one time. So the three keys that you press are what?
It's a function key. It's the left button key on your keyboard, right, on your Mac keyboard, and then option key just next to it. And then F11.
Perfect.
You can just go to view and then click here, this menu, this command button, or you can also use the shortcut command option G here. Let's use this command to access users. Juma is my cat's name and desktop and what was the name? Data folder. When I do this, VBA forces user to grant folder access here. So I select my folder and then grant access.
If we just switch back to Power Query right now, is it going to work? No.
No, it's not. You have to quit. I'm not talking about closing this files. You have to actually quit Excel.
Okay.
And then you have to start Excel. Now you can go to Power Query, create a blank query, and once again you have to use this command line, which is the simple command for getting the content of a folder, and then desktop data folder. Now we got this.
There we are.
This is really good.
That great icon there in that first to combine everything. You still get to choose just like you do in Windows.
Yes, it's going to create a sample pattern for you to combine the files. And
in this video now, we've had three lines of M code, one for table, one for web, one for from file, and one line of VBA code.
Yeah.
So four lines of code would have made Power Query on the Mac, twice as good. Everyone watching appreciates the fact that you went through 5 days of hell to figure this out to four lines of code.
I just wanted to make this easy for everybody who is using Mac, and because I've been seeing these questions online all the time, especially even yesterday, someone was asking about, can I access files in a folder on Mac? Why not? So. It's just easy.
Good.
This one line code in VBA.
All right, that's great. Good. So making Power Query on the Mac even more powerful by giving us access to from table or range, from web, and from files from folder. And just because I know someone's going to ask down in the YouTube comments, the other big one that's missing is from PDF, but we have no solution to that, right?
PDF. There's a PDF connector in Windows. So it doesn't exist on Mac. I don't know why, but it's just not a library yet. Power Query can still get the file content as a file into its container, but there is no connector. There's no adapter to read that file, convert that file from PDF to get the tables in it and put it into Power Query. Okay. So it just doesn't work yet.
All right, good. So,
but I believe that I certainly believe and congratulate Excel team even for this far. It's working great, really. Because I mostly need a Power Query using it both in Windows, on Windows and on Mac. Before probably 3 months ago, I didn't have this much. I was just able to use everything by using M code and limited capability. But now it's really catching Windows.
That's good.
So, thank you very much, Ray. Great. Thank you for letting me explain all this to Mac users.
Absolutely. All right. Thanks to everyone for watching. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, two more important notes from Suat. If you grant access to a folder using that line in VBA, that same permission grants access to all subfolders of that folder. And then for anyone who wants to do this without VBA, there is a way, but it's painful. And once you see all of this that follows in the outtake, you're just going to admit that VBA, one line of VBA is the way to go. But let's take a look at the other way.
Behind the scenes, actually, I would like to explain this because this is important. You can go to your user's library folder and containers and then Excel, data folder and library, finally, preferences folder. There's a file here, which is a plist file that Apple uses for settings. In the content, you are going to see all these files are bookmarked here. This is the folder name, if you'd like to access that folder.
And, but you can't just edit it with whatever your equivalent of Notepad is, because it's a binary file.
No.
If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.